This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. My name is the Reverend Heather Brannon, and I'm the pastor of this wonderful congregation. If you're tuning in from home for the first time, we welcome you here to worship and are glad that you joined us. As always, we invite everyone to greet one another in the beginning of the service. You can do so by leaving a comment letting us know that you're here. Now let us move from getting here to being here for worship. Our church has lots of exciting things happening. Here's just a few announcements. This morning you'll need a bulletin. You can find the bulletin on our website at wyomingpresbyterian.org or attached to the weekly email. Starting today on July 4th through the entire summer, worship will be remote on Facebook and YouTube. Worship will be available on both platforms at 10 o'clock a.m. on each Sunday. We'll have a big celebratory worship service back in here on September 12th. We can't wait to see you all then. Our mission trip team to Appalachia arrived home on Friday. They had an outstanding experience, reshingling roofs, building new decks, and general maintenance on several homes. What a blessing to be able to share God's love with our neighbors in Kentucky. You can follow their adventures up on Facebook and Instagram. This year, we are blessed to offer Camp Johnsonburg scholarships to 5 deserving children. We're sponsoring 2 children from Family Promise of Essex County, formerly IHN, and 3 children from One Hope, One Love. Please pray for these children as they prepare for camp here in July. There are several opportunities to get involved in the life of this congregation. Please check out the weekly email for more opportunities. And finally, we give thanks to so many people who have helped prepare and lead worship this morning. All of those individuals are listed in your bulletin. Please join me in singing our opening hymn, "My Shepherd Will Supply My Need." You can find the words printed in your bulletin.
My shepherd.
Friends, Jesus calls us to share peace with everyone that we meet, both friend, family, and stranger. At this time, I invite you to pass the peace with those who are around you at home, or to make sure that whoever you encounter next, you pass that peace with them. The peace of Christ be with you always. So with you. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable unto you, O Lord. Amen. Our first and only reading for this morning comes from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 12, verses 22 through 32. Hear God's word spoken to you. Jesus said to his disciples, "Therefore I will tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat, or about your body, what you will wear. For life is more than food, and the body more than clothing. Consider the ravens. They neither sow nor reap, they have neither storehouse nor barn, and yet God feeds them. Of how much more value are you than the birds? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to the span of your life? If then you are not able to do so small a thing as that, why do you worry about the rest? Consider the lilies, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin, yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like the rest of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, how much more will he clothe you, you of little faith? And do not keep striving for what you are to eat and what you are to drink, and do not keep worrying, for it is the nations of the world that strive after all of these, and your Father knows that you need them. Instead, strive for his kingdom, and all these things will be given to you as well. Do not be afraid, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Sell your possessions and give alms. Make purses for yourselves that do not wear out, an unfailing treasure in heaven, where no thief comes near and no moth destroys. For where your treasure is, there your heart will also be." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Do not worry, Jesus tells us in today's passage. Do not worry about your life, you of little faith. Do not keep worrying. Easier said than done. I'm the type of person who worries about all sorts of things. I care deeply about others, so it's hard not to worry when I know they're going through a rough period or unhappy or that they can't catch a break. I worry about climate change, the way we leave our beautiful planet for generations to come, if they will ever be able to see the stars with all that smog, if the forests will still exist as a sanctuary for our souls, if we don't destroy them first. I worry about the future of the church, the declining membership, the secularization of society, the mentality that God doesn't exist if we can't see God with our own two eyes. I worry about those who are suffering all around me, the homeless, the poor, the sick, my limited and unsuccessful ability to take care of all of them by myself. And of course, I worry about my own needs and that of my family. Even though I'm very well taken care of, always have food, shelter, and clothing, I still worry about all sorts of small, unimportant things in life, minor things that can weigh me down. So when I meet someone who is cool, calm, and collected, I wonder, Are they really human? They let things just roll off their backs, moving on with life without a care in the world. They claim that everything will be okay, that there's no reason to worry, that things will work itself out. But I imagine that deep down inside, these people have a parasite eating away at their souls, the manifestation of their masked anxiety, the result of pretending that every little thing gonna be all right. This ridiculous soul-eating parasite makes me feel just a little bit better about my own unrealistic anxieties. Jesus tells us, do not worry. But I imagine that for most of us, this imperative lives underneath a very worn-out rug rather than at the forefront of our faith. Anxiety is just a part of the human condition. In our passage for today, Jesus is trying to show his disciples what they should focus on in life. Most people are preoccupied with trying to survive, hoarding money, acquiring possessions that define their happiness and stability. So I have to wonder, why do we have an obsession with survival even when we're obviously going to be okay? Our basic needs are taken care of. What Jesus is trying to tell us is that our tendency to build up our storehouses is a result of a fundamental lack of trust in God, who's our ultimate source of nourishment. Our gravitation toward commercialism and materialism is the result of deep-seated anxiety. When Jesus says, "Do not worry," what he really means is, do not have anxious concern. Do not have anxious concern that you will go hungry, that you will walk around stark naked in public, that you will live out in the wilderness without provisions. Do not have anxious concern that God doesn't know about your suffering, your long-term unhappiness, your empty heart, your unfulfilled days when you no longer know what your life's purpose is. Do not have anxious concern about your children, their unplanned futures, your final days when you have no control over your ability to take care of yourself. Friends, God already knows about our anxious concerns. God never left us when things started to spin out of control. God is the one who should put our minds and our hearts at ease. So we need to stop letting anxiety control our lives. Let that anxious concern live with God, not deep within our souls, tearing you to pieces, making it impossible for you to be a disciple in a world that needs God's love more than ever. Let that anxious concern live with God so that you can live your life to the fullest. Jesus' ultimate point is to trust God and God alone. God will take care of you because God made you. Anything that gets in the way of this trust is a sin. God is our ultimate provider and source of nourishment. But at this point, I'm going to argue with Jesus for just 1 minute. I can't imagine a homeless person reading this text and agreeing with him. If you're already hungry, drowning in sorrow, and feel forgotten about by society and God, how can you expect God to provide for you? It seems like God forgot about the most marginalized people in our communities. But the very last part of this passage addresses this injustice head on. Jesus tells us that those of us with resources should share them abundantly. Purses wear out. The treasury of wealth is vulnerable to theft. So participate in generous giving to the benefit of the poor. Use your treasures to invest in others, allowing them to flourish just like you. This is what it means to be rich in relation to God. We are called to be disciples of Christ, giving up our old way of life to live into this new eternal life through our own baptisms. It gives God great pleasure when we go about life growing the kingdom of God, not stoking our anxieties. We can't be disciples if we let worry and anxiety stop us from trusting God. Living a life filled with anxiety is antithetical to being a Christian. It's our abiding trust in God that stabilizes us, not a bloated bank account. It's our abiding trust in God that gives us the confidence to take risks in life, not our status or influence. It's our abiding trust in God that puts our anxiety at ease, not our attempts to micromanage our lives and our happiness. Friends, don't let anxiety and concern control your lives. Give your anxiety to God so that you can be set free to live as a disciple of Christ. May it be so. Amen and amen.
Still my soul, the best thy
At this time, let us now pray for the church and the world. Let us pray. Gracious God, we struggle with the feeling of not having enough. We do what society tells us is right. We save up our money, we buy everything under the sun, we make sure our lives outwardly reflect our success. Yet we forget that this is fueled by anxiety. Lord, help us learn how to cast off the anxiety and doubt and lean on you for nourishment. Enable us to trust you with our concerns and trust that you will care for us. Prepare us to stop anxiety in its tracks so that we can focus on discipleship. Almighty God, we give you thanks for our robust mission outreach here at Wyoming Church. We give you thanks for our amazing Appalachia mission team, for their ability to spread your love, strengthen their friendships, and return home safely. We also give you thanks for the fortunate children who have an opportunity to attend Camp Johnsonburg this month. May their time together be a blessing, helping bring them closer to you. Lord, on this July 4th weekend, we are reminded of the sacrifices so many people made for our freedom in this country. We're reminded of the lives that were lost, the families that suffered, the wounds that still exist. We recognize that our freedoms come at a cost. We give you thanks for this freedom that we don't deserve, promising to use our freedom to do good in this world, making sure that we utilize our freedom in order to share your love with our neighbors all across the globe. God of compassion, there are many people who we are concerned about who are lost, hungry, sick, grieving, in need of your healing and comfort now more than ever. We pray especially for Barbara Abig, Andy Birnbaum, Deirdre Brown's mother and her partner Orlandis, Sandy Kramer, Karen Olson, Doug Reed, and Jim and Dory Winslow. We also pray for Jeff and Lucas Davis on their adventure trip to New Mexico. Make your presence known in their hearts. Providential God, we're ready to unburden ourselves of our anxious concerns, the things that weigh us down. While we start learning how to trust you more, we will continue to lean on the example that Jesus set for us, saying the prayer that he taught us, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen." Friends, thanks to all of you for donating and pledging toward the Tommy Thomas Fund. As of a couple days ago, we've raised $115,000 and counting. Our original goal was $110,000. What a blessing! We will set aside these funds for future repairs and work on the heating and cooling systems. Thank you so much for your generous contributions. And of course, as a reminder, we're called by God to share our gifts with the church and the world on a regular basis. Your gifts help Wyoming Church follow its mission to share God's love. You can send a check to the church office this week or visit our online offering plate at wyomingpresbyterian.org/giving. Thanks for giving abundantly toward our mission. Please join me in singing our final hymn, "My Country, 'Tis of Thee." You can find the words printed in your bulletin. Thank you. Friends, anxiety is a part of the human condition, but it doesn't have to stop us from trusting God. So as you go out into this world as disciples of Christ, know that you don't go alone. You go with the love of God, the courage of Christ, and the guidance of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.